the continuation with the Schrodinger wave equation, this is psi is a wave function which is of r, theta and phi, which is actually involves two functions. One is r, radial function, and this is for the angular function. So this is the radial part, and these are the equations actually we are getting by solving Schrodinger wave equation. Now if you see here, what is this? This is like a mess. How can we remember these equations? Not required at all. It is just for the knowledge. But these equations are useful to plot some graph, and from those graphs we can say or we can identify how many orbitals have nodes, or which orbitals has node or which orbital has not, where there is a maximum probability of finding the electron. And from that graph we can predict the shape of orbitals. So these equations like this, r1s, that is for first 1s orbital, is equal to 2 into z upon a0 raised to 3 by 2 e raised to minus sigma by 2. r2s is equal to 1 upon 2 root 2 z upon a0 raised to 3 by 2 2 minus sigma e raised to minus sigma by 2. 2p is equal to 1 upon 2 root 6 z by a0 raised to 3 by 2 sigma e raised to minus sigma by 2. What is sigma? Sigma stand for 2zr upon n a0, and a0 is h square upon 4 pi square m e square. Actually this is nothing but the radius of hydrogen atom. This is 0.529 angstrom. Okay, this a0 is nothing but radius of hydrogen atom. So if you observe carefully, these equations actually telling you about the orbitals along with shells. So first shell, 1s orbital, this one. Second shell, 2s and 2p orbital, and so on. We can derive so many equations for 2p, 3p, 4p, then 4f, d, 3d, everything we can derive by using this. Now this is not in this is not our cup of tea at this level, because as I already told you, to solve, to get these equations we required various iterations. These equations up to here we can solve manually, but for complexity it becomes very difficult, and in that case we need some softwares which are available. So these equations, what we have to understand from here, we have to understand only this thing. These are the such kind of equations are there which will tell us about the orbital, that is probability of finding the electron in a space around the nucleus. Well, x theta by phi is called the angular part. Okay, so now if you observe carefully, these are telling you about only orbitals. Okay, now here orbit as well as orbital, only orbital. So like s orbital, angular part 1 upon 4 pi raised to half, px orbital 3 by 4 pi raised to half sin theta into cos phi, py orbital 3 by 4 pi raised to half sin theta sin phi, like that. And from that, from these equations, if we try to plot some graph, then there are two types of a graph we can plot. One is r versus r. This r is a radial function, the radius. So for 1s orbital we can plot a graph like this way, r versus r, this way. This is for 1s orbital. Okay, now if we plot r versus r for 2s, so we have a graph like this way. Now this one, this point is called as, this point is called as angular node. Okay, this point is called as angular node, right? Similarly if we plot a graph for, so this is for 2s orbital. So if we plot for 3s, so r versus r, so we have a graph like this way. Okay, so if you observe carefully, we have now these two nodes. So this graph where it is cutting to the x axis, so that is called as a node. So we have a nodes for 3s orbital, we have a two nodes. For 2s orbital, we have a one node, and for a 2p or a 3d orbital, we are getting the same graph almost like this way. This may be for 2p or 3d orbital, 2p or 3d orbital. This is one way of representing the orbital, the radial part. There is one more way, that is called as a r square versus r. So r square is nothing but what? This is nothing but probability density, electron density. So if we plot a graph for 1s orbital, r square versus r, I'll be in a graph like this way. This is for 1s orbital. Now if we plot a graph for 2s orbital, okay, so we have a graph like this way. So we have this one node. So here we are considered the same thing. It is touching to the x-axis. So that is called as a node. Similarly, we can plot graph for 3s. R square versus R. And we are getting a graph like this way. So these two are nothing but nodes for 3s orbital, and if we plot a graph for 2p or 3d, the graph is similar like this way only. Okay, for 2p or 3d. So in JEE there may be a question based on this: which of the following represent a graph for 2s orbital? So what we need to check, it is what versus what. That is the first thing. Second thing, if it is what versus what, so if it is r versus r, then if you observe carefully, it is going to the negative side of y-axis. But if you observe r square versus r, all the positive values, so it is always above the x-axis, that is positive values of y. Okay, so that thing you have to remember. Then we need to find out nodes, angular nodes. Obviously we have to find out radial node. So how many radial node in a 2s orbital? So we have calculated that, and means if I am talking about 2s orbital, it has a one node, so it should cut to x axis at only one point. If I consider 3s, it should cut at two points. If the graph is between r square and r, then it's very simple. So this way they may ask you a question in JEE mains based on graph. So we can predict shape of graph for 3d as well as 3p, okay, or 4s orbital also, by knowing the formulas. What are the formulas? I just want to revise those formulas. Nodes. Okay, so total nodes, we have three types of nodes we have to consider. Radial node, formula n minus l minus 1, n is the principal quantum number, l is the azimuthal quantum number. Then angular node, right, l, what is that? Azimuthal quantum number, and total number of nodes, just we have to add these two. So that is what? N minus 1. So there may be a question based on this part. Okay, so if you understand this part, don't worry about these things, because this is only for sake of knowledge. No need to remember that part also. But why these graphs are coming? So these graphs are coming from such kind of equations. Okay, Now we'll solve few problems on Schrodinger wave equation concept. Okay, not on actually on the equation, but there are certain concepts which we use, and we'll solve few problems, and that will understand, that will help us to understand that Schrodinger wave equation concept in a very well manner. Okay, so that we'll see in the next session. Thank you.